Today I'm taking up five questions we're frequently asked about rigging and lifting a load. It's another Toolbox Talk. My name is Ben, and this is the Lifting and Rigging Channel. Today I'm answering your questions about rigging a load. You're the lift director here. If you have a question that you want answered, drop it in the comments below. First question. Which way should your shackle be rigged to your crane hook? Pin up or pin down? Great question. It depends. We need to first look and see what is going on below the hook. If more than one sling is attached to your shackle, first of all, you need to ensure that you are using an anchor shackle or bow shackle, the kind that looks like this, with a round bow. Second, the sling should be seated in the bow part of the shackle and not the pin. The lifting hook, or what is attaching your shackle to your crane or hoist, should be attached to the pin of the shackle. Now, if it is only one sling attached and you're lifting in line, it can actually be done either way. How high do you need to lift a load? Only as high as it needs to be to get where it needs to go. If you're moving your load 10 feet to the right or left and there are no obstacles in your way, do you need to lift it head high? No, only lift it as high as it needs to be so you can safely move it where it needs to go. Do riggers need to communicate with the crane operator using hand signals, or are you allowed walkie-talkies or verbal communication? There is actually no law or standard specifying how a rigger and crane operator need to communicate. It is up to you and the crane operator, or the lift director, or the safety director, to decide the safest way for communication to occur to ensure a safe lift. Although, I would suggest that if you are communicating verbally before any movement is made, you confirm the directions. If a crane or sling were to experience dynamic loads, but the load is half or a third the weight of the working load limit, would there be any danger of breakage or failure? First, let's define what a dynamic load is. The definition of dynamic loads is any load that changes over time. Now, if that time period is very short, it could be defined as a shock load. Shock loading can occur in any situation where the load on the crane and/or rigging suddenly increases. Intense shock loading can create stresses on the crane and rigging equipment many times the static weight of the load and is one of the most unpredictable causes of catastrophic failure. Four of the many factors that can contribute to catastrophic failure are: 1. The ultimate breaking strength, or UBS, of the slings and the crane. The working load limit is the maximum amount of weight or force that your slings can safely handle. Slings are manufactured with a degree of safety that compensates for mistakes or errors called the design factor. Meaning, if they are accidentally overloaded and the working load limit is exceeded, the sling should not immediately break. The ultimate breaking strength is the maximum amount of weight or force that the sling can handle before it does fail. 2, the weight of the load. What is the percentage of the load's weight as compared to the ultimate breaking strength of the lifting equipment? 3, the severity of the shock load. Do the created forces exceed the ultimate breaking strength of any component? And 4, the overall condition of the crane and the rigging. By using the equipment at a lower percentage of its working load limit, and of course, its ultimate breaking strength, you reduce the chance that the shock load force will exceed the ultimate breaking strength of the equipment. If any of the equipment is damaged, worn, etc., the ultimate breaking strength will be lowered and the risk of catastrophic failure will increase. So, yes, anytime we perform a lifting operation, there is always a risk of breakage or failure. The competent person performing the lift must take appropriate steps to mitigate that risk, including, but not limited to, a lift plan, including calculations to determine the factors we just spoke about, and a thorough inspection program for all cranes and lifting equipment. Some dynamic loads can create a lot of stress on the slings, regardless of the material they are made from or the weight of the load. There would definitely be a lot of concern about breakage or failure. Slings and other lifting and rigging equipment are designed to take up the weight of the load gradually and steadily. They work best with controlled static loads. That is the safest way to lift. Knowing that you are working with dynamic loads, you must be vigilant with your inspections and inspection criteria. Have a procedure or plan in place for inspecting your equipment regularly and often. If there is a danger of shock loading, I would recommend looking for an alternative lift plan. Last question. Do slings have a recommended or prescribed service life? For example, 5 years. So there's no service life for slings unless otherwise noted by the manufacturer. In theory, if any sling is adequately taken care of, it can last many years. As of right now, there is no requirement for a born-on date on the sling's tag. So, if the items pass a proper visual inspection, they're good to go. If you're looking for instructions on how to inspect your slings, an ebook is linked below, or you can check out this playlist right here. A good rule of thumb is that if you are questioning your sling, it is best to replace it. If you're looking for more information on any of these topics, check out the links in the description. We also have a ton of information on anything rigging related in our learning center at mozellacompanies.com. Not to mention, we offer lifting and rigging training both in person and virtually. If you have a question of your own, drop it in the comments. My name is Ben, and stay safe out there.